More now on Victoria's mushroom poisoning deaths, with yet another twist in the investigation. It's been revealed that Erin Patterson, the woman at the centre of the probe, told police she purchased the mushrooms at a local shop.
That new information comes as detectives order forensic testing on a food hydrator found at a local rubbish tip. For more, we're joined by Professor Brett Summerell from the Australian Institute of Botanical Science and criminal psychologist Tim Watson-Munro. Good morning to you both. There's so much to get through here, isn't there? First to you, Brett. From your expertise in this area, are you aware of shops selling poisonous mushrooms at all, ever?
Absolutely not. Not in my experience. I've never, ever actually heard of that. I think it's unusual. Most people who are selling mushrooms, either through the supermarkets or shops, are getting them from accredited producers, and the likelihood of a poisonous mushroom coming through from that source is really very unlikely.
Okay, well, that is good news for everyone watching. Brett, what would a food dehydrator be used for when it comes to mushrooms?
Well, it's pretty common to use it for mushrooms because mushrooms only fruit once a year, so there's a very limited time when you can actually go out there and pick them, particularly for people who are foraging for them in the wild. So what happens is you get some that you cook freshly, but in order to make them last throughout the year, it's a common practice to dehydrate them so that you can then add, you know, those dried mushrooms into whatever food stuff that you're producing.
Right, so it's not mushroom season now, is it, or is it?
No. What we generally talk about mushroom season between May and June, in that autumn period as the weather cools down after summer. So that's when we would see many of the poisonous mushrooms, as well as those mushrooms that people are really keen to go out there and forage for.
I was reading the description of the death cap mushroom, and it's pretty nondescript, really. It's white, kind of rounded or flat top. It's got those white gills underneath. It kind of sounds like any other mushroom. How do you spot a poisonous one?
It can actually be really difficult because many of the poisonous mushrooms also have, you know, compatriots, if you like, sister species that look very similar to things that people are keen on foraging. Death caps usually have a greeny to yellow colour when they're mature, but unfortunately when they're young they look very much like straw mushrooms, which can be quite popular for foragers. And then other species that are poisonous, like ghost mushrooms, look like oyster mushrooms, or yellow stainers look like the field mushrooms that you might see in a pasture or a paddock. So it can be really difficult, and one of the things I always stress to people, unless you're there with an expert who really knows the mushrooms in that area, it is really much too dangerous to go out collecting mushrooms without some experience.
Okay, so maybe stick with the shops. Tim, how unusual are mushroom poisonings as a cause of death?
Pretty unusual. There's much more common causes of death. Drownings, motor vehicle accidents, gangland shootings in Sydney and so on. There's about 100 people who die annually globally from mushroom poisoning. There's far more admissions to hospitals, though. And of those people that are admitted to hospital, about 30% of them die. So in the greater scheme of things, it's pretty unusual.
We need to stress Erin Patterson has denied any wrongdoing. But Tim, speaking broadly, how would police be able to establish the difference between an accident and deliberate poisoning?
I think a chain of investigation, Sherbo. So you would have the homicide squad looking at it, you'd have forensic people looking at it, there would be an analysis of all the material, and of course if this food dehydrator is discovered and there's footage surrounding that, that may point to a consciousness of guilt. I don't think we know enough yet to say definitively one way or another whether it's an accident or more than that.
Without a doubt. Brett, Tim, thank you for your time. Appreciate it.
Pleasure. It's always a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.
One thing this case has done is it's got Australia talking, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's just it's horrible for these three, you know, wonderful community members that, you know, were obviously just going to a lunch. No one knows what's happened. And this poor man, Ian, who is on life
still
support
recovering.
And will need a liver transplant because of what has happened to him. He is fighting for his life in hospital. And our thoughts are with all the families of those involved in this tragic case.